won the battle, and turned around and went on back up to Virginia, to Washington. Good strategy, bad strategy.
Bad strategy.
Bad strategy. Mm-hmm. What's the best thing to do? Burn it off. Burn it. So Atlanta, Charlotte. That's what it was, Charlotte. Burn them. That's what he did, burn them.
So see that city now, though.
Yeah, burn them. And that's why after the war, the Civil War, it was called the Great Reconstruction down there, because you got to build it all back up. The best way to set them slaves free is burn those plantations down to the ground. So the old Southern Confederate folks that had their tradition, their mama's land, their granddaddy's land, it got burned and destroyed. But the Bible way says, when you take a city, take land, don't burn it all, because you want to eat off of it. Wisdom. That's some kind of wisdom there, okay? But now, so that's what happened to the city of our lesson, verse 15. Our city is besieged. We got to do something now. So, here's what happened. Now, there was found in it a what kind of man? Wait a minute. Thought you had to be rich to be wise. Throwing my lesson off here. A poor wise man. Can someone kind of give me a description of this guy? And he by his what? Delivered the city. Yet no man remember that what? Whoa! He went from hero to forgotten. But it was something about this poor, insignificant man that saved and delivered a people. Do we have any modern day people like that? Yeah. Williams over there at Northside. No, no. Help me out. Is there any modern day folks like that around? Poor, insignificant, ain't got nothing going on, but got all the wisdom and delivered. Concrete proof. Wasn't for him stepping up to the plate, doing something, saying something, they would have lost all out.
There was Martin Luther King.
Martin Luther King.
How about Mandela?
Who's that?
Mandela.
Mm-hmm. 30 years in prison. He ain't got nothing going for him. They done took it all. But he somehow behind the scenes, he kept his organization intact. Martin Luther King. This significant. Even current president, Obama. There ain't time for no black man to be praying. Ain't nowhere in the world. Whoops. Guess where we at? How do you do that? How do you figure that out? How do you beat that political machine? How do you do that? Okay, so, but now this poor man, here's the key word in that verse there. Found. They found him. That meant that they had to go search. They had to go looking for him. He wasn't by accident. They had to go look for this guy. They had to. We are deficient in wisdom, and we got to find somebody in this city that's got some wisdom. And they found. They had to go find him. Okay, so they found this poor wise man, and by his wisdom, we don't know what he did, but he delivered the city against a great army. A small group of people against a great army. So don't despise what kind of beginnings?
Small.
Because all it takes is the right stuff to get you over the hump. And you become big. Now this guy, why did they forget him? What do you say, brother?
Because he was poor.
Because he was poor. Girl, I like that dude, Sister Debbie. And we read earlier about the advantages of what? Money. Solomon said, get it too, because it's your defense. Now, I used to have friends all the time. They said, oh, it's better to go through the eye of a needle than to be rich. I mean, something to do. That's better because if you're rich, you got money, man. You can't make it. Go figure.
Read the next verse.
Go figure. So this man got forgotten. He used wisdom, but he was forgotten. He saved the city, but he was forgotten. Doesn't seem fair. All right. Let's look at verse 16, and we'll look at some demonstrations of New Testament people applying wisdom and see if they were heard. Okay, verse 16. Read it, Sister Candy.
Then said I, wisdom is better than strength. Nevertheless, the poor man's wisdom is despised, and his words are not heard.
Brother Williams answered it, because he's poor. That's like some poor person that's, I'm pretty sure it's happened a lot of times in City Hall. We have council City Hall meetings, I think, every Tuesday or something around here. And you only get, if you're just some nominal citizen, you ain't got nothing going for yourself, but you got something to say, you get maybe 3 minutes at the podium if you're not on the agenda. Mm-hmm. Is that something like that, you know? And then, okay, go sit down. That's it. You said your piece. They don't take what he got to say to heart or nothing. You know, he might have all the answers to save all this money y'all spending on this and that. Don't try and build nothing down there. There's a creek down there. I've been living there for years and it's going to overflow and run the road out and everything. But y'all intend on doing it, don't do it. Okay, ding, time's up. Go sit down. Go sit down. Go sit down. So, here's the thing about wisdom. Wisdom does not flaunt itself. It's not loud. It doesn't bogart. It just tells the score. And I think when Kenny and I was young, we used to say, wisdom cried aloud. In the streets. Is anybody listening? You have to really do your to hear. So, let's look at some examples in scriptures. This is how the believers should be. Look at Matthew 12, verse 16, Matthew's gospel. And it's so easy to override wisdom. Anybody ever overridden wisdom by going wrong? You know, because he don't fight. Yeah, he don't fight you. He ain't gonna have to fight his way to get his way. You know he's right, but you know, it'll take you, make your choice. Matthew, what did I say? 12:16. Someone got it. You're gonna have to read the 16th verse through the 21st verse. Well, look at verse 15 through the 21st.
15.
Okay. Anybody got it? Mm-hmm. Okay, someone to read it.
But when Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself from thence, and a great multitude followed him, and he healed them all, and charged them that they should not make him known, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Esaias the prophet, saying, behold, my servant, whom I have chosen, my beloved, in whom my soul is well pleased, I will put my spirit upon him, and he shall show judgment to the Gentiles. And he shall not strive, nor cry, neither shall any man hear his voice in the streets. A bruised reed shall he not break, and a smoking flax shall he not quench, till I send forth judgment into victory. And in his name shall the Gentiles trust.
All right. Okay, now see, the Pharisees wanted to destroy Jesus in verse 14. And Jesus knew it, and he got away from them. And in verse 15, those that decided to follow his teachings followed him. Then he turned around and he did what to them? He healed them. See, he's teaching, and teaching most of the time precedes healing. So he's given them his words, and those that chose to follow him, and then he got them healed. And then, now you ought to go back and show them. Come on, man, let's go back. They should have followed us. Come on, here we go. But he says, no, don't do it. Don't put my work, don't publicize my great work.
Yeah.
Just let it go. Just let it go. So how many guys been in sports before? And you got another opponent talking about how much they call it trash talking. You know, trash talking. I'm better than you. I'll run a sucker, all this and that. And you have a tendency to do what? Give it back. But the best thing to do, coaches tell you all the time, what? Let it go. I'm going to knock your socks off if you come around this way again. And coach, you have a tendency to get into a fight right there and talk about what he said instead of getting back to the huddle or getting back to the team and proceeding on with the game. And some teammates have to just come to you and say, let it go. So this is what Jesus is saying to them. Let it go. He didn't need to get, he says, I know who I am. I know what I can. Let it go. And then another thing it says here about wisdom, it does not have to get a riot going or a mob mentality to have itself heard, known. That's what he said. You don't have to shout and fuss and stand up and jump up on the desk and throw stuff and all like that. And you're in a political debate, business debate, organizational, whatever you're coming up with. You don't have to do all, just sit back down. And just say to yourself, they ain't hear me. They ain't listen. You still got the real stuff. You got the real stuff. Let's look real quick. Am I running out of time?
10:15.
Okay, give me 5 minutes, please. Okay. Let's look at the one, the Apostle Paul, Acts the 27th chapter. We gotta find our right spot. Okay, it's the gist of the story. Verse 5. And when he had sailed over the sea of Cilicia and Pam. Well, he came to Mara, see. And there, the centurion found a ship of Alexander sailing into Italy, and he put us therein. When he had sailed slowly, slowly many days, and scarce was come against, what is that? How about you, college grads? What is that? Send us. The wind not suffering us, we sailed under creek over against Salome. And hardly passing, and then barely made it, came into a place which is called the Fair Heavens, which whereunto was the city of Lycia. Now when much time was spent, and when sailing was now dangerous, because the fast was now already past, Paul admonished them. And someone with some wisdom, read verse 10.
And said unto them, sirs, I perceive that this voyage will be with hurt and much damage, not only of the land, of the lading and ship, but also of our lives.
Now that's wisdom. That's what he said. He said, "Man, I don't think we should go this way. I don't something should go up, you know. Sir, you know, you might want to reconsider that, Mr. Bossman, Mr. Leader of the organization, whoever you may be. You just speaking up, wisdom. Wisdom has discerned, experience. And he says, I don't think we should do that. Are they going to listen to Paul?
Nope.
Who's why? Because he's a lonely prisoner. Getting ready to kill you. What you know? Besides that, we do this what? All the time. Who do you think you are?
We're the experts.
We're the experts. We know this. You know, chill. It's what we do. Sit down there and get ready to die. Get your last meal. Shut up.
And it wasn't that he didn't want to go there, because he was the one that they would have let him go a long time ago, but he insisted on being brought before the...
Okay, so they didn't take Paul's advice, as it says in verse 11. Nevertheless, the centurion believed the who? The master, which is the pilot, and the owner of the ship, more than those things which were spoken by Paul. And because the haven was not common, what is that word?
Commodious.
To water. In more part, advised to depart thence also, if by any means they might attain to Phoenice, and there to water, which is in haven of Crete, a creek, and they lighted toward the south and west. And they went on about their business. Now let's see what's going on here. Verse 21. Well, we got to look at verse 18.
Yeah.
We've been exceedingly tossed with tempest. The next day, they lighted the ship. But somewhere along there, they ran into some problems. I think that's about verse 17. In verse 19, in the third day, we cast out our own hands the tackling of the ship. And when neither sun nor stars in many days appeared, and no small tempest lay on us, all hope that we should be saved was what? Taken away. I told you we shouldn't go. That's what Paul could have been doing right now, wouldn't he? Told you. Stupid. That's what the Bible says. Don't even do that. Wisdom don't even say, I told you. But after long abstinence, Paul stood forth in the midst of them and said, Sirs, you should have hearkened unto me and not have loosed from Crete to have gained this harm and loss. Now I exhort you to be of good cheer, for there should be no loss of any man's life among you, but the ship. You think they're going to listen to him now?
Yeah.
Yeah,
they did.
Okay. Well, how do you know so much, Paul? How do you know so much? Verse 23, what did he say? How do you know so much? What's his answer? I mean, that's me, but
for
how did he know so much?
By me this night, the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve.
All right, because I got hooked up.
Fear not.
To wisdom. And the angel said to me, Fear not, Paul, thou must be brought before Caesar, and lo, God hath given thee all them that is in cell with thee. So this is where 1 Corinthians 1 and 30 comes in. We have the wisdom. We have it. And if you just sit and listen, wisdom will tell you what to do. Discernment. Should I go on this trip? Should I drive? Is it okay to drive? It might be clear skies, 85 degrees, not a cloud in the sky. How many have been on the road like that?
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, whoa, we should have went on this trip. Wisdom was telling you that when you was packing the suitcase, but you didn't listen.
Wisdom said, check that forecast.
Check that forecast.
You know it.
Brother, you ever been out there and fishing below the dam and then you hear the horn?
No, I haven't done that. I've heard about it.
Yeah.
I need no better.
Really? The horn is almost too late. It's a little bit fast.
Break it out.
Yeah. Remember, if something's stuck, it's stuck, okay? But I'm out of here. And I sounded the horn.
The water's coming.
The water's coming. You better get the moving. So This, so wisdom is this thing that, you know, you just, either you got it or you what? Yeah, you know, either operating with it or you're not operating with it. Life experience it, discernment, and able to use what you got. That's it. You know, Solomon took it and built a fortune. Mm-hmm. just sitting down and figuring it out. Well, what's life going to be like 20 years from now? Solomon says, the sun will rise and the sun will set. Same stuff I'm working with today will be here then.
I think a good point about wisdom, though, that this story points out, we didn't keep reading, though, mm-hmm. that just because wisdom is overwritten, mm-hmm. don't mean it goes away.
That's right.
It still comes back, and later on, Paul had to tell them what they had to do to be saved. In verse 30, it says, and the shipmen were about to flee the ship, mm-hmm. when it let down the boat into the sea, mm-hmm. under color, as though it would have cast anchors out of the ship. Mm-hmm. And Paul said to the centurion and the soldiers, except these abide in the ship, they cannot be saved.
Mm-hmm. So
they were, you know, their thought was that the right thing to do is get away from the ship, it's about to be broken up. Mm-hmm. But wisdom came back and told Paul how to save mm-hmm. their lives. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So wisdom is it's not boxed in. It's like, what am I going to do today? And what am I going to do next 5 minutes from now? Wisdom is gotcha. But if you ain't tuned, if you're not tuned in, or you override, well, you
tell
I let the fool go.
Wisdom will get you back on course.
Wisdom will try and get you back. He said, you know, hey, what can we say? And some folks just override it, ignore it all day, all the time. Mm-hmm. And blame everything on everybody else. He said, you know, Paul said, Solomon said, same thing for me, for you. You know, what you going to do with what you got? What's it going to be like years from now? Well, the sun come up and the sun will go down. I got that much. Winter will be winter, summer will be summer. We got that much. And when it's 90 degrees on me, it's 90 degrees on you. What are we going to work with? How are you going to work with that? Somebody determined that I think I'll get me an air conditioner in here. Back in the day, they had outhouses. It's 20 below zero. I'm tired of walking out there freezing, getting to the outhouse. Nobody in here knows what an outhouse is. Freezing. And they freeze by, get back here.
Did you ever go to an outhouse?
Yes, I did. And it was more than the cold weather that was a problem. So somebody said, we're going to put one of those in the house.
Yeah.
What? I'm sure there's nobody. No, you're not going to do that. We're going to put one of them in the house. No, not in the house I'm living in. But wisdom came up with this idea. Now no one goes out, right? It just goes to the room. So there's a lot of problems with them outhouses.
We got two more verses to cover.
Okay, go ahead, Daniel.
10:30.
The words of wise men are heard in quiet more than the cry of him that ruleth among fools.
All right. No,
wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinneth destroyeth much good.
Yeah. Wisdom is better than anything you have.